Hi everyone. Hi. It's Sheila McPhee here. And boy, we've got some beautiful sunshine coming in the window right now. Hi everyone at Pine Grove. Victoria, just let me know if you're here and if everyone's ready to paint this lovely little cupcake for Father's Day. Aw, I know you can see me, but I can't see you. So I hope you enjoy this wonderful little tutorial, the little paint party on a Monday night. Beautiful night in Fredericton. Oh, I just gotta fix my bangs. Oh, wrong way. I just gotta fix my bangs. No, I put them to the wrong side. Do you think my comb is big enough? I forget which way I wear my bangs. Help me. Somebody help me. Anyway, we got the bangs sorted out. So here we are. So I wanted to say hi and thank you for joining me. And I hope you all enjoy painting this cupcake together. It should be lovely. So I'm going to move my camera down and look at the canvas. And I hope to see you all soon. And everybody take care and happy painting. So we're going to go down here. Now here we are in our little cupcake. Isn't that a pretty little cupcake? Yummy. You could just jump right in that there with your hands, couldn't you, and decorate. So that's what it's going to look like, the finished product. Isn't that pretty? And we're doing this for Dad for Father's Day. And I hope you got your little button that says, number one, Dad. You're the frosting on my cupcake. Isn't that cute? I love it. And then there's a sticker. So you'll be able to take those and put them wherever you like. So here we are, the little cupcake. I'm just going to sit this aside. Oops, look what happened. I forgot to finish tracing my cupcake. So I'm just going to finish this off right here while we're visiting. And I already had it pre-traced. And I'm using a black marker here to go over those lines. Makes it really stand out, doesn't it? There we go. There's the bottom of the cupcake. Now we're going to just trace around the frosting. Like that. Isn't that great? Trace like that. And do the other part. And the top of the cupcake. Looking good. Oh, gee, that looks nice already. And then we'll put in a couple little detail lines, like that. And then we've got our little black and white eraser images, and we'll paint those in after. There we go. Just like that. There. Awesome. Okay, put that marker away. So we're going to start off. Oh, we do need brushes, don't we? Let's get a brush. Where's my water? Water and brushes come in handy when you're doing a painting. And maybe a little paper towel. So we're going to start off with black. We're going to do the background first, all in around here. Just going to take a little bit of black paint and we're going to start painting that background. Now I don't want you to get too close to the cupcake, this part right here. I just want you to go near the edge because we're going to leave a line. I don't like that brush. Let's use another brush. Let's get a different brush. Some black paint. Very good, Sheila. I'm going to have a black cupcake. The frosting. So see, we're just going to go in. We're not going to touch that cupcake with the black outline. Just take our time. And just move that paint around, and we're going to continue on up the cupcake, the frosting. See, we're going to have a little ledge around. That little white ledge right there. We're going to leave that white. Take a little bit more paint, and I'm sitting in this beautiful window, and the sun is just beaming in. It's just gorgeous. It's just going to dry the paint while I'm putting it right on my brush. So continue on and spread that paint around. And we're going to do the little sides. I always like to do the sides of my painting, like that. Just hold it up. Just don't need much paint at all. It gives it a nice finish, you know, if you do those sides. And then we're going to go finish putting that black in close. Not touching the frosting, just in close to it. And we just take our little brush, go like that, and finish filling any little white spots you see. You want to make sure all your canvas is painted. And just spread that paint out. Smooth it out nicely, and we're going to paint the top, the edge, a little bit more black, fill that in, there we go, hope everybody had a chance to get outside today. It was a glorious day, and I've seen some of you out on that bicycle. Good for you. What fun. Oh, what a good time. And you have just a beautiful little paradise down there with that trail and your own bicycle. Oh my gosh. It's fabulous. And it's so nice to get outside, isn't it? It's just been so beautiful the last few days. So now we're going to go finish with the black, not touching the frosting, remember? You can't touch the frosting yet. No. And you just fill in that black. Mm-hmm. Come down here. Go around, just follow around the outline of your frosting. Looking good, isn't it? That black makes it really stand out. I don't think I've ever seen black frosting, though. No, I'm sure you can make it. You can do anything with frosting. My favorite is boil frosting. We used to make chocolate cakes every Saturday and put boiled frosting on them when I was growing up. They were delicious. Boiled icing, frosting, and chocolate cake. Yummy. That was pretty special. There we go. There. Look at that. A little bit, missed that part right there, Sheila. There we go. You know what? That's almost dry because it's so sunny in here. You can see the sun rays over here. Look at that. Aren't they pretty? So pretty. I could close the blinds, but I think it's quite nice. It's lovely. Okay, so we're going to, and why don't we, while we're here, you see how we have these racer marks right here already? So I think we should do that right now. Okay, taker, and we do every other one black. Okay, that one. And this one. Kind of makes it look like a little racetrack, doesn't it? Kind of a dad thing or a guy thing. I like racetrack. Okay, now we're going to do that opposite one, black. And we're going to leave that little edge around the bottom of the cupcake. Like that, see? I think my door just blew shut because I've got the window open and it's blowing so nicely in here. Nice fresh air. So you just skip every other one and fill in that black. Kind of looks like the racer's flag, doesn't it, on the racetrack. Very good. Excellent. And then we're going to do the other side. And we're going to do this one. Easy, fill that in. Fill in that one right there. Don't go too close to that cupcake, Sheila. Don't want to make the cupcake cranky. And then we'll fill in this one. Yep, looks good. And we'll fill in this one. Look at that. My goodness. Looks lovely. Then we can go in after and we can get a little bit more detailed there. So we'll give that a chance to dry. Nice. So then we're going to go and finish painting our edge. Paint that edge. Because the top is dry. Mine's dry. So, and if you get a little paint on your hands, this is water soluble, so it'll wash right off. No worries. So, now we're going to paint this edge. Nice and black. It's looking pretty snazzy already, I'd say. I can't wait to see yours. Just going to turn this around for a minute so I can get this edge done nicely. There we go. Awesome. Okay, got that edge done. Oh. It's going to look really nice in your room. And then we've got one more edge to finish right here. Just decide. There we go. Do you find when you paint, like, you get really quiet? I find I'm like that sometimes. You're concentrating so hard, like, you just don't want to talk and you just want to focus on your creation. So there, I think we got all the edges covered. Cool. Looking pretty sharp. There we are. We'll put the brush in our water, clean up our mess. I'm gonna take a little smaller brush now. Just a bit of a liner brush. I'm just going to straighten out some of those lines. Smooth them out a little bit. Don't look too bad though. I'd hang this cupcake on my wall. For sure. Does that look okay? Yeah, I think that looks good. Yeah, it looks really good. Yeah, Super. We've got that edge right. Okay. Okay, we're all right with that. Right, I made a little boo-boo right there, didn't I? So, going to clean our brush out, and our paper towel. We have some white paint, and we're going to add some white paint to that checkerboard. Yeah. Really, it just takes one little sweep. If you've got a larger brush, see, it just, wow, that's magic. All you need. Paint on that side. And, oh, got a little bit too much paint on that one. There we go. Just fill in those white parts. And there. That one. And this one. Very good. Awesome. I'm going to put a little white paint over that boo-boo I made there. I don't want that black showing through on that other color. There we go. Wow. Zippity-doo-dah. Okay. I just wanted that for you. Okay. Okay. Now we're going to get serious. Looking good, though. It's a nice black and white painting. It's pretty nice. See? Isn't that lovely? So we're going to take our small brush. Take our small brush. And we're going to dip it in. I have turquoise. See, turquoise and blue. See? Turquoise and blue. Pretty colors. Turquoise is very popular these days. Oh my gosh. There goes one of my gray hairs. Should have saved that one. Okay, here we go. There. You see that okay? Very nice. Okay, I gotta get another. I'm just getting a little messy. I better smarten up. Okay. There we go. Take it out of the shadow, out of the sunlight gray there. There we are. So what we're going to do, take our brush, and we're going to dip it in the turquoise, and then we're going to dip it in the blue. Okay? And then we're going to start filling in the bottom of the cupcake. And just go back and dip a little blue. It's going to be a combination of blue and turquoise. And when you dip it in both pots of paint, it kind of gives it a marbly effect. And don't worry if you go over the black line. We'll fix that after. So. Okay. And dip. We can double dip here. Double dip in the blue and the turquoise was fun. And then you just go back and dip in the blue. Get a little blue. And we'll get a little turquoise. Yep. Really makes it look very, very pretty. Okay, blue and then turquoise. Okay, do it that way. We'll do the opposite way. And we'll get some blue. I thought blue and turquoise would be a nice color choice for Father's Day, don't you? Too much paint that time. a little curve going in my paintbrush here. It wants to go one way. Okay, we're just going to keep filling in those little white faces on the cupcake. The little cupcake, what did they call them, cupcake holders? Oh my gosh, we used a lot of those growing up. Holy cow. Cupcake liners. I mean, we'd bake all day Saturday. Saturday was a big day for us growing up on the farm. We'd bake at least 200 donuts. Oh my gosh. And banana bread, and cupcakes, and molasses cookies, and oatmeal cookies. Because we had to have, I grew up in a family of 9 children. We weren't all home at once, but there still was a lot of school lunches to put up, and we'd have to take the bus to school, so we had to pack our lunch in the morning, eat cookies, and sandwiches, and fruits. We always had apples, oranges, and maybe a banana, maybe. That was pretty special, having a banana. And when we did have a banana, you had to cut it up so everybody had enough to cover 9 kids. And that banana was pretty thin. But, you know, that's what you do when you grow up in the country, on the farm, and everybody, you just make enough till it goes around for everybody. So we always had fun cooking on Saturday. It was a big day at our home. Cooking and cleaning. Yippee. Oh, well. But the house sure smelled good. It's a cross between cookies and Mr. Clean. I don't think we had Mr. Clean then. We probably just used vinegar and good old soap and water. Anyway, it was nice. Lots of good memories growing up on the farm. Oh, that cupcake is filling in nicely, isn't it? Isn't that beautiful? Well, I hope you're enjoying this. I'm so thankful to be here with you tonight and have you paint this cupcake together with all of us. It's a pretty special moment. Aww. Uh-oh. It sure is. And Father's Day is this Sunday, I believe. Yeah. It's coming up. It's coming up soon. So we just keep dipping, double dipping. We're almost there. There we go. And if I'm going too fast for you, you can always come back into this group and the video will be here. So don't worry about not getting it all done. It'll be available for you to go on the replay, and Victoria can help you with that. And you can just follow along, because everybody paints at a different pace. There we go. With this program that I'm using, I'm painting upside down. So if I had this turned towards me, it would be like that. And you would see it upside down. Okay. But that's okay. I would rather you be able to follow along like this, okay? So long as that's clear. I'll turn it around in a bit because I'm going to have to fill it in, and it might be easier if I filled it in with it being right side up. That's okay. Oh, we're almost done the bottom part. Yeah. And when you're finished, don't forget to sign it. Every artist should sign their creation. Yes. That's looking great. I love it. Almost looks like a Dairy Queen topping right there. Ice cream. Yummy. Dairy Queen. I love Dairy Queen. I'm going to take my marker. I didn't go down far enough on a couple of these lines. I'm going to do that now. Just so. There, that's better. Much better. And then I can go right to the edge of that black. And like I said, don't worry about going over the black, because we're going to go back in and go over the black. You can. This is a time it's okay to paint outside the lines, because we'll fix the lines. Too fun. It's almost like a paint by number without the numbers, isn't it? You just fill in the blanks. I love this kind of painting. So wonderful. Stress-free. And relaxing. Oh my gosh. So relaxing. Father's Day, there we go. I know they make great cupcakes at Pine Grove. Oh, awesome cooks there. Their kitchen. Woo! Mashed potatoes. Turnip. I love turnip. Carrots. Yummy. There. See, I'm getting used to this program. That looks nice. It turned out good, Sheila. Very good. All right. Okay. Well, maybe I've got a couple little places I can add a little bit more blue and turquoise. Lovely. Okay. Now that's going to dry pretty fast right there in the sunshine for sure. Now we're getting ready to go into the top part. The frosting on the cupcake. There's a cupcake under that frosting, I know. But I'll just take the frosting. Oh, it'll be so good. All right, so we're going to get a bit of a medium brush or whatever brush you have, whatever you're comfortable with, whatever's available. Clean that off. And we're going to do the same as before. We're going to use pink and yellow and orange. I see. Oh, okay. Actually, no, I made a mistake. First of all, we're going to do, I see now, we do have red there. Silly me. Oops, see, there's red right there. And then there's yellow. Okay, so let's get a little bit of yellow. There, yellow. And we're going to just follow along that line at the bottom of the frosting. I almost forgot about this part. It's a good thing I looked at my reference painting. I'd be in big trouble. So there. Very good. I'm going to add a little bit of orange to that yellow. Yeah. That's pretty. I like that. Yeah. Add a little bit of orange, like double dip, yellow and orange, yellow and orange. And it doesn't have to all blend in. Just kind of let your brush go over it, and once it dries, it looks like it really is. You don't want it to all be flat looking. This way it has a little bit of style to it. Okay, now we're going to take some red, just red, no double dipping here, no double dipping with the red. Then we're going to fill in that little bottom part, just around that little ruffle. Yeah. It's okay if you go up into the yellow. Makes it more dimensional. Yes, it does. Doesn't have to be perfect. If you want a perfect painting, take a picture. So, and every painting's different. I mean, I know there's a number of you joining me tonight, but all your paintings are going to be different. And isn't that wonderful? That's the beauty and freedom of putting your touch on it. Everybody has their own creative identity. And that's what's so exciting. When you inspire to desire your creativity, look what happens. See? Got the red and the yellow. Very nice. Good job, Sheila. Good job. Okay. Here we go. Just need a little bit more of that turquoise a couple of places. Fill in our gaps there. Awesome. There. Beautiful. Okay, now I think we're ready for the frosting. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. So we're going to double dip here. Let's start down here, down in this little corner. And we'll go with some pink and some yellow. I love pink and yellow. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. Wow. That's almost fluorescent. This could be a cupcake that glows in the dark. I never thought of that. Holy cow. So if you get up in the middle of the night and you're hungry, you'll be able to see your cupcake because it'll be glowing. Oh, wouldn't that be fun? That's a glowing cupcake. Oh, too funny. Okay. There. Now the next one. Some pink. I've got two different shades of pink here. If you have it, that's great. If not, that's fine. Ooh, la la. Isn't that pretty? Yummy. Yes. Oh, there's more fluorescent. So, guaranteed. Wouldn't that be funny, though, if you had a certain kind of frosting that glowed in the dark? It probably is. Kids would love it. Yeah. Oh my gosh, too funny. So you just put your paint, put some yellow over that pretty pink and just stroke it on. You don't have to make it all flat and blend it. Sort of chop it up a little bit. Makes it more artistic, has a little bit of flair to it, and you don't have to have it perfect blending with all the colors. Oh, looks so pretty. Now we're doing the next one. Look at that. Oh, I love pink and yellow together. Oh, I love working with those colors. They're so bright and happy. A little bit of orange and pink and yellow. Double dip, just keep putting your layers of paint over the top of each other, following along. And again, don't worry about going over that black part because we'll go over it again later once it's all dry. So, no worries there. Almost looks like the color of the sun coming through that window right now, that yellow. Beautiful. I was just thinking about when we were growing up and we'd have to take the school bus and pack our lunches. And then coming home on the school bus, it was always like, who's got anything left in their lunchbox? So we'd be sharing on the school bus all our little goodies or whatever we would have left. It was fun. Lots of fun. I think it's great when you can bake and cook and be creative that way. I mean, everybody has a creative gene in them. It's just not with paint. You're creative with numbers. You're creative with music. You're creative with cooking. There's so many artistic things just waiting. Crocheting, knitting, making quilts. We did a lot of that too. Yes, sir. Oh, look at that. Ooh la la. Yummy. Looks good. What do you think? Does it look good? It's quite pretty, isn't it? I like that pink. Very nice. That sun's kind of giving us a bit of a glare. I could get up and close the blind. Okay, don't go anywhere. I'm just going to close that blind. It's quite enjoyable, though. Oh, is that better? You can still see that sun coming in. I think you can see it better like that. Looking good. Can't wait to see yours. Yummy, yummy, yummy. So we're just going to let that dry. Blend that in a little bit more. Looks good. Oh yeah. Little bit of yellow on the white there. Bad yellow. Bad yellow. Go away. So now what we're going to do is get our black paint back to the black. Back to the black. Back to the black. And there's not a whole lot of real fixing up we have to do. It's just your own preference if you want to make that line a little cleaner and a little straighter, and that's fine, but it looks good the way it is. I mean, it's your painting. I think it looks rather stunning myself. Doesn't have to be perfect. And I'm just going to go over the little black lines a little bit. Make them a little bit more enhanced. Yeah, like that. Very good. I think this would make a great greeting card, wouldn't it? Number one, Dad. You're the frosting on my cupcake. Isn't that cute? I like that. Oh, there you go. You just kind of go back and go over if you like. If you're happy with the way yours is, that's fine. Nobody's going to judge them. It's going to be a masterpiece, for sure. It's good. I'm just going to go and take my black. I'm going to smooth out that line around the top of the cupcake. Fill in a few little gaps there. Oh, look at that yellow. How'd that yellow get there on the black? Gee. Just smooth that line down. Like that. And over and down. Got a couple of little spots there that need covering up with black. Fix that right up. Okay. And you can go back in and go over those black lines that we had there in the beginning. Can you see my gray hair? My gray hair. I'm letting my hair go gray. And that's all right. Quite nice. So you just fill in the lines of the frosting, make them just cover up your little paint that you went over on those lines. There you go. See, I told you not to worry about those. Yeah. I think this is probably where the saying came from, watching paint dry. When you do a painting, I mean, you wish it would dry right away, but that's all right. Okay. And then just go over that other spot there with the black highlight. Give it a little distinction. Right here. I think there's a great cupcake business at the market. I'm wondering, well, the market is just coming back. It's just opening up. Yeah, they sell cupcakes there. Yeah, that's looking pretty snazzy. See how going over that black makes it really stand out? Just cleans it up a little bit too. Yep. And the racetrack, or the race flag. I'm gonna get some white. I'm just gonna use some white. And go over that again. There's something I saw. Oh, I think it was over here. What I do when I paint, I like to take my painting and look at it in the mirror. It just gives me a different perspective, and I can see where I need to change something or add something or make it go in a different direction or use a different color. So mirrors come in handy, real handy. Still have a couple little black spots here, so we're going to just fill those in. There, I think I got them all. We did that. Those sides in the beginning, it looks good. She's looking good. Can you hear that dog barking? I have a barking dog neighborhood. It just It barks when it goes outside, then it barks when it goes down in its little pen, then it barks when it goes on the patio, then it barks when it wants to go back inside. It barks when it wants to go out, and then it barks when it wants to go in. He's a cute little, looks like a little Scotty. He's a sweet, cute little pup, you know. But he's quite a barker. He keeps everybody hopping. There's our Father's Day cupcake. Isn't that beautiful? I think that's very nice. I'm happy with my cupcake. I hope you're happy with yours. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to come up and say goodbye, but I'm going to give it a try with this new program, okay? Oh, there I am. It worked. There's our cup. Oh, look at that window. That sun is just beaming in. Anyway, I can't get away from it. It's too late to move the table now. Anyway, it's going to be a nice evening. So thank you so much for joining me. I had fun, and I hope you did too. And I can't wait to see your pictures. Don't forget to share them with us, Victoria. Okay? And I hope you are able to, maybe they'll make some cupcakes this color at Pine Grove. Who knows? So I hope to see you soon. So, bye for now. Love you. We'll talk to you later. Thanks for joining me. I really appreciate it. Bye.